Myself, Prasad, working as assistant professor in Department of Mechanical Engineering in MBA College of Engineering and Technology. Today we will discuss about ceramics and composite metals. So it is our last unit one. So in this MMS syllabus one, it is the last unit, and these are the topics one, ceramics and composite metals, two important topics one. So define ceramics and define composite metals, and ceramics, classifications of ceramics one, and the classifications of composite metals one. Advantages, disadvantages, limitations, applications. So these are the topics about the overall 15-1. So sir, we'll discuss about today, we will discuss about composite materials. So what is the composite materials one? So composite material can be defined as combination of two or more materials. So the combination of two or more materials is known as the composite materials. So the combination, nothing but here, the having significantly different physical or chemical properties one. So two or more composite materials we are using one. So the two or more metals, nothing but here. So different physical and chemical properties of materials we are getting, and we are combining one. So these result in better properties, and then those of the individual components one. So the combination we are using two or more one, different physical and chemical properties materials we are using and manufacturing one. So we can see the final object one. So better properties and those of the individual components one. That is one of the important definition of the composite materials. So the constituents retain their identities in the composites. That is, they do not dissolve or otherwise merge completely into each other, although they act in the correct one. So the combination we are tweaking, we are taking two or more metals we are using one, different physical and chemical properties of two or more metals we are using one, but the combination is very important one. Two or more metals combination one, or clubbing one, or merging is very important one. So the merge completely into each other, although they are acting so concurrent one. So after then the merging is completely we are merging equally and perfectly. So after then we can use this kind of material are used to manufacture parts one. So the composites are one of the most widely used in materials because so of their availability to different situations, and they relate to case of the combination with other materials to serve specific purpose and exhibit desired properties one. So compared to other materials, so it is one of the very different materials are used to manufacture different types of materials one, very specific manufacturing systems, and these are. So the main advantages of the composite materials are their higher strength and stiffness we can see. So one of the main advantages of the composite materials, why we are using these composite materials, means these are high strength and high stiffness materials. These are, so high strength, high stiffness is very important. So that's why these are very important materials. So the combined with the low density when compared with bulk materials. So when combined with the low density and compared with the bulk materials, so these are the very high strength and stiffness materials. So what are the applications means generally, so by using these kind of materials, so what are the applications means, some example one, I can say a few examples through applications about the composite materials means they are used for manufacturing purposes. So which kind of manufacturing purpose means, some example one, aeroplane purpose we can use it, aeroplane body frame manufacturing purpose you can use it for composite materials, and various engineering applications, nothing but these are used for construction of bridges, underground pressure vessels one. So next one is these kind of materials are used to manufacture automobile car body frames one. So next one is these are used for so sports equipments. So sports equipments, nothing but such as bicycles, golf clubs and tennis rackets. So these are the some of the examples are some of the applications of the composite materials one, generally some live examples one. So next one is see another introduction of the composite materials means a composite material is multi component systems
with at least a matrix reinforcement. So these are the general properties of the composite materials. So high strength to wear rest, wear weight ratio, wear resistance, corrosion resistance, greater fight to life, low electrical conductivity. So low electrical conductivity, and next one we can see lower cost and easy processing. So these are the one of the introduction about the composite materials. So different kinds of parts, some special parts manufacturing purpose, you can use it for these kind of materials. But materials, we have a lot of materials. Engineering materials, we have the different kind of materials. Ferrous materials, we have non-ferrous materials. We have ferrous material are used to manufacture the different kinds of parts. One, non-ferrous materials are used to manufacture different kinds of parts. One, so not are same parts. One, we cannot use same materials. One, different kinds of parts manufacturing purpose, you can use the different kinds of materials. One, so that one, the in this world, that one is one of the material is composite materials. So next one we can see, it is one of the very different material, ceramics matrix composite. It is one of the ceramics matrix composite one, CMC nothing but. So this material have ceramics as a matrix material. So in this one, the ceramics act as a matrix material. In composite is called as the ceramics matrix composite one. So in ceramics, we have the so matrix material, so that's what we can call as it is a ceramics matrix composite one, CMC. So what are the properties of CMC one compared to composite materials? So we have this CMC, composite material is different. So in one of these another different kind of material is nothing but CMC, ceramics matrix composite one. So what are the properties of CMC means? So say here, tensile and compressive behavior is a very important one in CMC one. Next one is fracture toughness one. Next one is fatigue resistance. So these kind of properties are very important in the composite materials one. So see here, the first one is tensile and compressive behavior. So see, no sudden failures in CMC like as ceramics. And certain amount of elongation in CMC improves the tensile and compressive properties. So no sudden failures. The failures are, we can see in CMC one, so very less. Why? Because they are improve the tensile and compressive properties. So that's why the failures. Failures means nothing but so sudden broken, sudden cracks. So these are the one of the failures. But in these materials, the failures we can see very less. Why? Because they are improve the the tensile strength and compressive strength. So that's why there's no sudden failures we can see in the composite materials. Some example one, we have the other kind of materials also. Some example iron we have, steel we have, and some example were known for brass, aluminium, steel, bronze, brass. So different kind of materials we have, different kind of materials are used to manufacture different kind of parts one. So, but each and every material, the properties are very important one. Any kind of material, the properties are very important one. The properties is good, the product one is also very good one. So the lifetime of the product also more one compared to other materials. So in this one, so the sudden failures are, we are reducing. Why? Because they automatically, they are improving the tensile and compressive strength one. So next one is fracture toughness one. Toughness are very important one. So in this one, we can see fracture toughness, we can see fatigue resistance also, we can see in the CMC one. So next one is continued with another properties means thermal response. Thermal response also very important. Why? Because it can withstand high temperature. So high temperature, it can be withstand one. So next one is chemical inertness one. So chemical do not react with ceramics do not react with chemicals one. So the ceramics are do not react with the chemicals one. The corrosion resistance also you can see in this one. So next one is advantages of CMC one. So excellent wear and corrosion resistance in the wide range of environment and temperature one. So next one is high strength to weight ratio, high strength retention at elevated temperature one, high chemical stability one, non-catastrophic failure one, high hardness one, light in weight, So these are the advantages of the CMC. One of the advantages, excellent wear and corrosion resistance we can see in the CMC one. High strength to weight ratio we can see in the CMC one. High chemical stability we can see in the CMC one. High hardness we can see on the CMC one. Light in weight we can see on the CMC. So next one we can see disadvantages of CMC one. Machine should we have advantages, disadvantages also. One of the disadvantages means the processing routes for CMC involves the high temperature. In processing routes, the CMC involving the high temperature. High temperature we are using the so CMC one. Why? Because the major disadvantages high temperature we are using one. So why? Because we are improve the toughness. So CMC are designed to improve the toughness of monolithic ceramics. So the main disadvantages of which is brittleness. Brittleness is very important. Why? Because at high temperature we are using one automatically. The brittleness is improved for any kind of materials. That is the ceramics or composite materials or steel or aluminum or iron, whatever it may be. So the brittleness is very high temperature. We can use this kind of material automatically. The brittleness also increasing one. So high processing temperature results in complexity in manufacturing and hence expensive processing we can see in the CMC one. Difference in the coefficient of thermal expansion one. So the major differences we can see in the CMC one. So thermal expansion is very important one. That is a thermal expansion differences we can see in the CMC one. So between the matrix and the reinforcement lead to thermal stresses on cooling from the processing temperature one. So these are the disadvantages of CMC one. So next one is what is the applications, general applications of the CM composite materials means. So it is a composite material applications, so cutting tools. So using the composite materials to made the cutting tools one. So the cutting tools, why? Because it is a very hardest material, hard, high compressive strength and toughness. And strength, we can see this kind of materials, cutting tools one. So next one is we can see aerospace. By using composite material to manufacture aerospace one. So see here, this is aerospace body frame one. This total body frame is manufactured for composite materials. So next one, see here, this body frame completely manufactured for composite materials. Next one, we can see jet engines. Jet engines manufacturing purpose also you can use it for composite materials. So next one is we can see burner. So burner also very important. This also one kind of material, one kind of part one. This one, this burner making purpose you can use it for composite materials. Next one is turbine blades. Turbine blades are very important. Why? Because in some example turbine blades we can use it for waters. So the in water we are using the turbine blades. Corrosion resistance also very important one. To prevent the corrosion resistance, so this is a very important one. To prevent the corrosion resistance are very important any kind of turbines one. So machine should in turbine blades in this one composite materials mostly it prevents the corrosion resistance. So that's why this material are used to made the turbine blades one. Hot fluid channel. So hot fluid channel also very important one. So by making of the these by the composite materials are used to make this kind of materials, hot fluid channel one. So next one is we can see some of the advantages of the composite materials means they are light in weight and lower density. So mostly probability the composite materials are light in weight and lower density. We can see that is one of the advantages one. High creep resistance. So high creep resistance also you can see on the composite materials one. Strength to weight and stiffness to weight and greater than the steel or aluminium. So strength to weight we can see, stiffness to weight are greater than the steel or aluminium. These are the stiffness to weight are more greater than the steel or aluminium. Fugitive properties are better than the common engineering materials. The fugitive properties are better than the engineering materials. Composites cannot be corrode like steel one. So it cannot corrode the like a steel one. Easy of fabrications of large complex structure shapes. So easy of fabrication is easy of fabrications are easy of manufacturing is very important. So large complex structural shapes. Some example one jet engines, aerospace engines. So these are the very complex structure shapes. So this kind of shapes to manufacture, we can use it for composite materials. Our modules are modular construction purpose also. You can use it for composite materials. Ability to incorporate sensors in the material to monitor it and correct its performance. Smart composites. So it is one of the very important advantages. High resistance to impact damage one. High resistance to impact damage is one. That is one of the advantages one. Improved corrosion resistance one. So by using these composite materials to improve the corrosion resistance. So it is one of the very important advantages for the composite materials one. So limitations are very important one. So see here in this composite materials, the limitations are very important one. High cost of raw materials and fabrications one. The materials are high cost compared to other one. Why? Because so very complex shapes by using this material to manufacture complex shapes one. So that's why. So these are very cost material. These composite materials are very costly material one. Next one is composites are more brittle than rough materials. So composites are more brittle. They are brittle than rough metals and thus are more easily damaged one. So these are the one of the limitations of the so composite materials. So next one is transfer properties may be weak. The transfer properties are maybe weak for the composite materials one. So the matrix is weak, therefore low toughness one. So the matrix is very weak, therefore the low toughness one. So resistance and dispose may be difficult one. So difficult to attack one. So very difficult to attack in this one. Difficulty with analysis one. Cost can fluent one. So the cost also very high compared to other ones. So high cost materials. These composite materials are one of the high cost materials. So this it is the introduction of the composite materials. So composite materials, so define composite materials and advantages, disadvantages, applications. And limitations. So it is our today class, Amma. So it is a composite materials introduction. So next class we will discuss about ceramics. So what is the ceramics? Ceramics is nothing but it is the inorganic compounds of metallic and non-metallic elements is known as the ceramics one. So ceramics is nothing but it is the inorganic compounds of metallic and non-metallic elements. So not for it, non-metallic elements is known as the ceramics one. Ceramic is a inorganic compounds of metallic and non-metallic elements. It is not an organic one, but it is a inorganic one. It is a natural materials. So the characteristics we can see on ceramics one. So high shear and compressive strength we can see on ceramics one. They have resistance to a high temperature creep one. We can see it has hard and brittle, high melting points we can see on ceramics one. So thermal and electrical conductivity is very low. So in ceramics one, ceramics has good thermal and chemical stability. We can see on ceramics one. So it is the introduction and it is the ceramics one. So the ceramics class we will discuss for next class one. So it is the today class. So once again, you can see the composite materials means. So see here, composite material. What is the composite materials? And advantages, disadvantages, and applications of the ceramics composite materials means. So see here, composite material may be defined as the combination of two or more materials. The combination of two or more materials. So the two or more materials is nothing but here different physical or chemical properties. So the combination of two or more material, different physical or chemical properties we are using, and we are merging completely into each other one. After then we are using that composite material merging completely into each other one. After then, we are using the material and manufacture different kind of materials one. So it is called as the composite materials. The combination of two or more materials is known as the composite materials. So what about ceramics? Ceramics means is nothing but it is inorganic compounds of metallic and non-metallic elements is known as the ceramics one. Ceramics are inorganic compounds of metallic and non-metallic elements is known as the ceramics one. So is the definition. So next we can see it is the introduction of the composite materials. So next one we can see another introduction we can see on the composite materials. The composite materials is multi-component system with at least a matrix and reinforcement one. So these are the general properties of the composite materials. High strength to weight ratio, wear resistance, corrosion resistance, so lower cost, easy processing. So these are the one of the properties one. So it is one of the ceramics matrix composite one. Ceramics matrix composite, it is the CMC one. So it is one of the very important material. So these are the properties of the CMC one. Tensile and compressive behavior we can see on CMC one. Fractures toughness we can see, good toughness we can see, good figure resistance we can see on CMC one. Next one is thermal response is very very good in CMC one. Chemical inertness also very important in CMC one. Corrosion resistance also very good in CMC one. So next one is what is the advantages of CMC one? So in CMC, what is the advantages means in this one? Excellent wear and corrosion resistance we can see. High strength to weight ratio we can see. High strength retention at elevated temperature we can see. High chemical stability we can see in CMC one. High hardness we can see in CMC one. Light in weight, these are the light in weight we can see in the CMC one. These are the advantages of the CMC one. So disadvantages of CMC we can see here. Why? Because high temperature are used to manufacture this kind of parts one. So that's why when we are using a high temperature, automatically the brittleness also increasing. So that is one of the major drawback. These are disadvantages for the CMC one. Next one is applications. What are the applications of the cutting tools means? So see here, cutting tools. So aerospace one. So jet engines. So these are one of the applications for the composite metals. So next one is burner. So next one is turbine blades. So next one is hot fluid channel one. So next another advantages we can see on the composite metals. So these are the limitations. So it is our today class. Thank you, Amma. So next class we will discuss about the